Hello friends, welcome to Asha Wealth YouTube channel. In this video we will discuss about General Insurance Corporation of India IPO. The registered and corporate office of the corporation is in Mumbai and the IPO registrars will be Karvi Computer Share Private Limited, Hyderabad. The IPO will open on 11th of October 2017 and will close on 13th of October. It is a 100% book built issue. Face value of the shares will be Rs. 5 per share and the price range is 855 rupees to 912 rupees. There is a discount of rupees 45 per share to retail individual investors and employees. Minimum quantity is 16 shares and in multiple thereof, and the minimum application amount is rupees 13,872 rupees and in multiple thereof. Listing will be at BSE and NSE. The finalization of basis of allotment will be done by 18th of October. Initiation of refunds will be done by 23rd of October and credit to demat accounts will be done by 24th of October. And listing of shares is scheduled on 25th of October. The issue size is fresh issue of 1.72 crore amounting to rupees 1569 crore rupees approximately, and an offer for sale by the Government of India, that is 10.75 crore shares amounting to rupees 909,804 crore rupees. So the net issue is 12 crore 47 lakh shares amounting to rupees 11,373 crore rupees. Out of this, employees reservation portion is 12 crore rupees, QIB is 50%, NIB is 15%, and the retail is 35%. The promoter of the company is President of India acting through the Ministry of Finance. The corporation was incorporated on 22nd of November 1972 as a private limited company. On 7th March 2016, the corporation was converted into a public limited company. Let us know about the company. The company or corporation is the largest reinsurance company in India in terms of gross premiums. They provide various general insurance products like property, energy, marine, engineering, miscellaneous, aviation, hull, spares, rotor wing, aviation hull, spares, fixed wing, liability, aviation treaty, spares and liability insurance products. They also offer cargo and offshore energy, motor, life, agriculture, space, health, credit and financial insurance. They offer reinsurance solutions for the Afro-Asian region and reinsurance programs in Southeast Asia and Middle East and Africa. They develop their overseas business through their home office in Mumbai. Branch offices in London, Dubai and Kuala Lumpur, a representative office in Moscow, a subsidiary in the United Kingdom that is a member of Lloyd's of London, and a subsidiary in South Africa. The offer comprises of the fresh issue and the offer for sale. The objects of the issue for offer for sale is corporation will not receive any proceeds from the offer for sale, and the second part is fresh issue. Corporation proposes to utilize the net proceeds from the fresh issue towards, number one, augmenting the capital base of the corporation to support the growth of their business and to maintain current solvency levels, and the second is general corporate purpose. Now let us know about the company financials. Total assets as on 31st March 2013 were 28,139 crore rupees, and on 31st March 2017 the amount was 48,527 crore rupees. Total revenue in 2013 were 2,511 crore rupees, whereas in 2017 the amount was 3,644 crore rupees. Profit after tax is very good. On 2013 31st March the amount was 2,289 crore rupees, and in 2017 the amount was 2,858 crore rupees. As far as the peer group comparison is concerned, there are no listed reinsurance companies in India, so it is not possible to provide an industry comparison in relation to the corporation. Now, let us know about the plus and minus points of the company. First of all, plus points. It is a leader in Indian reinsurance industry with 44 years of experience. The second is, they are having international presence. It is a diversified product portfolio and revenue streams. Strong financial track record and strong balance sheet. The corporation is having experienced management team. The next point is, despite mega issue, the corporation is not going to have anchor bidding. Average of 3 financial year earning per share is 34.81 rupees and return on net worth is 16.61%. Price to book value will be almost 4 times after the issue. Asking PE ratio on diluted equity after the issue is 31. So, in our view, the issue is fully priced. As far as the listing, for listing gain is concerned, you should avoid this fully priced IPO for listing gains. And if you are a long-term investor, you can apply for long-term investments. Thank you for watching our YouTube channel, Asha Well. Please subscribe our channel, like and share to your friends. And we are waiting for your valuable comments. And you please do not forget to read the disclaimer. Thank you very much.